Every year, 800,000 people kill themselves, and every death impacts the family members and the people around them. Turning suicide out from their challenges in life because they just want to exit from this nightmare. Many of these lives can be saved just by lending an ear. So the uncertainty of our jobs, our relationships, it takes a toll on our health. So today, we want to dedicate the talk to something very important and close to my heart, actually, on mental health and what family and friends can do to support those people in need. So welcome to Jules Tea Channel, and we have a special guest here today, and I would like to introduce my friend here, Rosaline Chan. I know her about almost 20 plus years, and actually I know her through Toastmasters. So I actually, as you know from my YouTube channel, I actually got to gain back my confidence from Toastmasters, and very thankful for that. So when I met Rosaline, she really bring a lot of life to Toastmasters and taught me a lot about speaking in public. Throughout her life, Rosaline has been endlessly volunteering her time and skills to support the causes that she cares about. She was previously an ex-Befrienders. Befrienders is actually a global organization that gives emotional support to people who are suffering from depression or suicidal. So I'm sure you know of people close to you, your family members, or your friends, your close friends who are suffering from depression. So I'd like to ask Rosaline today, you know, why do people fall into depression?
Actually, there are many factors that people that could lead them to depression. It could be a loss of a job, loss of a loved one, rejection, marriage falling apart, rebellious children, which is quite obvious nowadays, in-law problems, work stress, insecurity, low self-esteem because maybe they have never been taught to value themselves when they grow up, bad childhood, maybe abused childhood, bullying. Bullying is quite rampant in schools as well. So sometimes, that could lead to depression and financial loss. I think during this pandemic, financial loss is a great problem and many people are suffering. Yes.
That's true.
So these are,
We can see the people around us, you know, even during the pandemic, so many shops have closed down, so many businesses have actually collapsed. And, you know, from their secure income that they used to support their family, now they have nothing to depend on. So it's very understandable what people are going through, and we need to be really, really sensitive to the people around us. So Rosaline, what are the signs that we should look for in people who are suffering from depression? Because sometimes you may be able to see if the person tells you, sometimes you're not. So what do we look for?
Actually, there are two types of people. One type, they appear very normal. No one notices, because I think the reason is because they don't want their loved ones or people near them to worry for them. So they live life as it is normal, and they go around doing things. There was a latest suicide case somewhere in, I think it was in the Sarawak. He went around even 2 days before he committed suicide. He could even do charity. So no one noticed. He was a president and he was still so bubbly and all that. He was cheerful. But who knows, 2 days after that, he took his life. So these are the type of people we don't know. They are very normal, outwardly. So they are struggling, but they don't want to share. That's the reason, because they don't want people to worry for them. His case was a family issue. The other type, they really show it. You can see, obviously, the family members can see that they don't take care of themselves, they lose appetite. Some people, they go drinking, and then they are very unkempt. They don't bother about cleanliness, hygiene, and they just dress whichever way they want. And they are easily offended. Anything will agitate them. When you talk to them, they get very uptight. So these are the people who show signs. I think it's better that they show signs than people can recognize, rather than keeping to themselves, then no one knows. So I think there are two types. Yeah, there are two types of people that you are able. One, you can identify. Another type, you cannot identify. Yeah.
So once when we identify such people, who actually can help them? Mm-hmm. Can we help them ourselves? Or what should they do if they feel depressed? What is their channel that they can go to?
What channels? Actually, family members are very important. Family members to watch out if there's any signs. Because we will not know a person is depressed. As the colleague, he may not show you. But of course, unless it's very obvious. So a family member or a close relative, they are the best people to go out to reach out to them. And you want you all to know how to help them. Then maybe to show them love, show them that you are there. No, these are very good ways of helping them. They need people, they need someone to talk to them, to listen to them. In fact, to listen more than to talk to them. Yeah, this is the time.
If they tell us the problem and we don't know what to do, and who else can they look for? What kind of organizations can they look for? Maybe there are professional people that maybe you can recommend?
Correct. They are, like I said, they are befrienders. And there's a whole list of care for Penang. Under PG care, there are a few. We have this, Suchi, I think they have one group. I think there are a few organizations, maybe we can put it up later. And also, they can also go for psychological or psychiatric help. It is not wrong to go for professional help, remember that. If we cannot help them, we ask them to go for professional help. Don't worry about that, because it's very, nowadays a lot of people go for psychiatry or psychological help. It is not because they're mental. Because the most people will say that, oh, they have mental case. But it's very common nowadays. People go, they can recover. And sometimes they need a little bit of medication. Medication is not wrong if they really need it to cool them, to calm them down. In small doses. Yeah. It helps for the time being. So at least it will make them more calm. Yes.
Is it okay for people who suffer from depression to tell this to their employer or their employees? I mean, it's some people feel ashamed.
Correct.
What do you think?
I think having a mental problem, it is better to tell the employer. I have one friend who jumps from job to job because he has this problem. He didn't want to tell. So when he goes to another employer, this problem comes in. Then another employer, this problem comes in. So who can help you? Only the employer. If you tell the employer, especially if you have worked for a few years, rather than jumping to a new company, it's better to reveal that to them. Then they will be very sensitive and they will help. I'm sure any human being would want to help your employee, if you know him, right? You want him or her to get well. So I think it's not wrong. It's not wrong to tell the employer. Then they can help him. And last time I was working in a big organization, when we feel that the person has some mental problem, we are very sensitive towards the person. And because it's a big organization, we put him in a place where there's less stress, so that he can concentrate on his whatever problem to settle his other problem. Yes.
Yeah.
So the employer plays a very good part, very big part too. Yes.
Yes. I think we must empathize with people that,
right,
you know, face stress instead of, you know, pushing them. I think we need to understand them and give them space. I think that's
correct. Sometimes it's also
an important realization that people should have.
Correct. Not only family stress, sometimes they may have work stress. If they don't talk it out, maybe this is the problem. the company will be able to help him, maybe transfer him to the another department or whatever. So maybe he couldn't take the stress from that department or that superior. So I think it's good to talk it out. It's good to talk it out. Don't keep it. The longer you keep it, the worse it will become.
Mm-hmm. That's true.
Yes, yes.
So how, you know, as caretakers, as a family member, how can we give the right support when we see our loved ones going through difficult times? What can we do to prevent suicide from happening? Because you can see in pandemic times, you can see our own loved ones, our friends, when they tell us they have problems, what are the right words to tell these people? Because I'm always lost for words when I encounter some such situation. I don't know what exactly I should say.
Sometimes it's better not to say anything. But you have to show love. Show them, give them a hug. Family member or a good friend, man to man, woman to man, woman, of course. So also tell them. I think communication is very important here. As Toastmasters, we learn about communication too. Listening and communication. Mm. So you listen to them, you ask them to tell you, to share with you. Share with you what are the problems they have. Tell them, I'm here for you. And you must be sincere. You don't say, I'm here for you, and then you disappear. I'm here for you. Please share your problem. If you need help, I'll try to help you. If not, we will try and get the right source for you. Okay? But always tell them you love them. And tell them that life is very valuable. No, everybody loves them. Because at that moment, they don't know that they have lost love, I'm sure. Love is anything. If they have lost love, then too bad. That means they say they are like no one, nobody in this world. You know?
Mm-hmm.
So it's sad. It's sad. Even successful people can feel like that. Can feel lost. They feel that I'm so successful, but there's something that I need that I didn't get. Love. It could be love. It could be care. It could be a family environment which they don't have. So always listen to them. Listen to them and be with them. The issue is quite difficult. Maybe he said, maybe I can talk to the alum or whatever. Yes, why not? Why not? You talk to them. Or you get a family member to talk with them. You go together and talk with the alum. Possibly they will have a compassionate heart and lessen their burden by, you know, reducing the interest or whatever. There are people, there are cases I've heard before where someone goes with them, some authorities go with them to meet the moneylender and to solve the problem. So you see, it can be solved slowly but surely. Then the moneylender relented and then knew his problem, it was genuine, and the case was solved. I've heard and I've seen cases personally. So I think there are many issues which can be solved. But of course, if someone rejected his love, it takes time for him to get over it. It takes time to get over it. So there are many, many ways of solving a problem, but not overnight. Like sickness. If the person has a sickness, you can't say, tomorrow you'll be healed, you know? You just be with them. Say, go for the right treatment. Some people will ask them to buy this, buy that to get well. So try to tell them to go to the right source, get the proper treatment, get it treated. I'm sure in time to come they will be cured. Recognize the problem. Just recognize the sickness. If it happens, it happens. It can happen to anybody. Happen to anybody. Yeah.
What else?
Give them hope. Yeah.